Oh, come on, Eileen. Chop chop.
I could give her a toot if you like.
Bugger off. Easy, girl, easy. That's it, all right, yeah. Oi! You could have hurt her, you big brute.
What, standing still? Look, I understand you may be frustrated, but please don't...
All right. You said your piece. Now shut it, okay? Good.
Sounds like he could use some peace himself.
So he just told me to shove off, Boston. I thought it was quite rude, wasn't it? Oh, sorry. Just when you mentioned he had a horse, I wondered if I'd recognised him from somewhere. Oh, yeah, I know. He's Mr. Strava. Who's he?
Head of the Environmentalist Committee in the Council. Mr. Cardio told us about him once. He was brought on not too long after Bunker had his accident. Almost seems coincidental thinking about it.
Oh, yes. Must have slipped my mind.
Speaking of... Do you know what happened to Flynn Sanity's money after the hearing? Went back to his family, I think. Personally, I'd have kept it for my own benefit. I could have taken Joanna on a date to some posh restaurant somewhere.
Boston, you turnip! You don't need £10,000 to eat out. Those transportation costs wouldn't have paid themselves.
Well... Common symptoms do correlate with how she's been recently. Refusal to walk, lying down. But I wouldn't say the disease has had time to build up, as with most cases.
Then she can be cured, right?
Absolutely. Might I recommend you bring her up to her headquarters in Lowley?
I couldn't walk her.
I could lend you Mr. Cardio's number. You could phone him and hire a private train. Cheaper than a lorry, and it covers most of the distance.
Come on, Eileen, off to the stables for you. Good girl, good girl. We may just have the solution for these problems you've been having. Dare say I don't like it much, but desperate times call for desperate measures.
You're needed for a train today, Boston. The horse box will be required.
I tried fitting a horse in a box once. As a result, I'm ostrich-sized from the animal kingdom.
We'll have to run to the junction and fetch it. They've got one in the yards. You'll need to collect the horse from Idlington Holt and take it to Lowry. That's, it's Mr. Strava's.
Mr. Strava's? Could I retire early instead? That sounds like a much better plan, doesn't it?
Believe me, he hates it just as much as you do. But it is only so far to go. And it could have been worse.
Worse?
Most of these horse boxes go in the back of express trains.
Ah, I see. So it's better if he has his own personal train to boss around.
And you can use that, pizzazz of yours to your advantage. Don't go too far, though. He is still a customer, and you are representing the railway. Don't forget that.
Yeah, leave it to me, Mr. Cardio. I'll give Mr. Strava a ride he won't forget any time soon.
For better, not for worse.
Right. Shouldn't be too long now, Eileen. Consider yourself embarrassed. What a disgraceful yard. I've seen doss houses that look better than this.
What if I told you this was a doss house? The railway equivalent to a doss house, anyway, nitwit.
I agree, it is quite a mess, isn't it? But this is one of our lesser used yards, you see, so what you gonna do? you afford a horse, then? Quite an expensive hobby. I didn't think your position paid that highly.
Eileen is not a hobby.
Oh, no, of course not. Sorry.
I didn't realise she was a vocation. She's a dearly devoted old friend. We go back years.
Time traveller, are you?
Are you always this irritatingly dry?
Till it rains, anyway. Oh, come on, Mr. Strava, let's not fight. Let's just get to know each other, yeah? I'm Boston, the best shunter around, subjectively speaking. Well, come on, tell me a bit about yourself.
I'm not entitled to tell you anything about myself. Oh, good, we know where we stand then. Why have we stopped? Wrong sort of snow or something? Damn right it is, it's invisible snow. You're not gonna believe this one, Barry. I'm only taking Mr. Strava's horse to the next station. What a sad coincidence. What, is it sick or something?
Sick as a dog.
Thought as much. I'd better be off. As the saying goes, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it sink. You mean drink, Boston?
Oh yes, silly me.
All right. Lewis Carroll should have put him in Wonderland, not Alice. Horses are quite privileged on the Great Western. Cows and sheep, they all share the same truck. But horses, no, they get their own.
As if this railway wasn't already a health and safety nightmare.
It'd be a clutter to give every animal its own truck. It'd be like a hierarchy system. Hold on. Can anyone smell something funny, or is it just me?
I can smell it too. Come to a stop, Boston. Found it. It's a hotbox.
The horse box has got a hotbox. And I have a sandbox. I'm really thinking outside the box today, aren't I?
What's a hotbox? You see this square thing in front of the wheel? It's an axle. Keeps the wheel bearing in place. What's happened is that the bearing has rubbed against the axle, creating friction between the two surfaces. Ergo, the axle has become hot. Just need some lubrication.
Wait. If it's hot, does that mean it could catch fire?
What? Goodness, no.
Mr. Strava?
Come on, Eileen, I'm gonna move you out of here or we're both gonna die together, all right?
I've never seen a wagon that spontaneously combusts before.
Don't be silly, Mr. Strava. It's not gonna catch fire. Shut up, tow rag.
I can't wait for horse boxing to take the spotlight.
Alright, let me sort this. Where did I leave the blooming... here it is. The axle box has cooled down now, Mr. Strava.
What have you done?
I threw some tea on it.
How ridiculously unprofessional.
Wait a minute, Mr. Strava. You do realise you could have just sat in that compartment the whole time, right?
What compartment?
See those windows? There's a seat there.
As long as it doesn't go up in flames, I'll take it. Strike two. Strike three. Ding, ding, ding. We have a new champion. How do you know the rules of boxing? You're a train. My Bromsgrove supervisor was a boxing champion. He won an award for packaging something in the quickest amount of time. Thank God that's over. Railway should have just stayed a fad of the Victorian era. I saw a leader once and thought the same thing. They're not doing well in America, are they? You better thank your lucky stars I'm not involved with the Transportation Committee. I would, but my lack of a telescope makes that rather difficult. Otherwise, you'd have lost your home ages ago. I've said it before and I'll say it again. You lot destroy our precious country and you're corrupting the government.
Corrupt the government? Then again, when you take the wars into account.
Shall I list any other shortcomings, or have I made my point quite clear already? Send them by post.
Sounds like you two had a nice time.
Words don't do it any justice, Bunker. Ugh, today was eventful. My hotbox had a horsebox. Really it did. Indeed it really. Would I be correct in assuming that's probably the last time we'll encounter Mr. Strava? Right, you're probably. Boston, stop it. Should I? Why? It's getting old. Hairs of grey, plenty it has.
I don't understand. Why did Mr. Strava have to take his horse by train? Couldn't he have hired a lorry or something?
Private trains are supposedly cheaper to hire than lorries. Since they're new.
Well, then I suppose we will be seeing him again, when his horse recovers anyway.
Mr. Cardio will have to decide which of us is going to take her back, right? Yes, Boston? Then I suppose we shall have to hear it from the horse's mouth.
I've got blisters on my buffers.